This is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. Today we have another exciting episode for you. I'm here at the San Francisco 2011 Indoor Gardening Expo. So while this is an indoor gardening expo, it's mostly about hydroponic gardening. So while I do have a hydroponic set in my kitchen, I'm mostly involved with outdoor gardening, although I think hydroponics can be an excellent solution for some people if you don't have space outside or even to grow inside during the winter. I'm not going to really cover a lot of hydroponic stuff today. I'm going to cover a couple things, but we're going to cover some of the booths here that I really like. So we're in the expo here, man. This place is huge, and I'm glad actually there's a lot of people here. So many people are into indoor growing, and I hope they're growing their fruits and vegetables inside so that they can eat healthier instead of eating all that processed food. But anyways, let's check out a few of the booths that I think can be really valuable for you guys as a home grower. Now, this video is not necessarily going to be for the hydroponics grower, although I'm going to show a few things that I think are really cool. Most of this hall is filled with all these nutrient solutions that I'm not too keen on. So let's check out some of these booths. So now we're going to check out the booth of nature control. And the reason why I like this is because a lot of people always ask me, hey, John, what do you do for insects and bugs? You know, what do you spray on your stuff? Well, I always try not to spray anything on my stuff. The first level of defense I have in many cases is using some beneficial insects, such as these guys right here. You can see they have a little aquarium here. And check it out inside, man. There's just like literally thousands of ladybugs. And ladybugs are really good because they will eat things like aphids, fungus gnats, mealybugs, scales, spider mites, thrips, and white flies. So let's go back into the back of Nature Control's booth and check out some of the pests and some of the cool insects and beneficial insects you can use so you don't have to spray those toxic sprays in your garden. Check it out. This just illustrates it perfectly. Pest controls Mother Nature would use. And you can see a praying mantis there eating a bug. I mean, that's how it works in nature. I mean, nature's been growing on for thousands of millions of years, and that's how it works. So we want to emulate and do things like nature would do and not try to like bring in toxins and chemicals into our environment to, you know, fight our pests. Here's a really good sign I like. And you can see it says, you know, if you have aphids, you could use things like ladybugs, green lacewings, pirate bugs, aphid parasites, aphid predators, sticky yellow traps, and these are the non-toxic and beneficial controls. Caterpillars, you could use caterpillar parasites. For flies, you could use fly parasites or traps. One of the common problems, I was dealing with some scale, actually just yesterday I had scale on my neighbor's tree, and I bet the first step was just to cut it all off, but otherwise you could use some ladybugs, green lacewings, pirate bugs, or mealybug destroyers. Some of the common pests that people have are maybe spider mites, where you could use ladybugs, green lacewings, pirate bugs, spider mite predators, spider mite destroyers, or these guys, I don't know, Feltalia ascarasuga. For thrips, they got, you know, these bugs, and for white flies, you know, you could use ladybugs, green lacewings, pirate bugs, white fly parasites, white fly predators, and sticky yellow traps. So in my opinion, the best way to deal with bad bugs are to have good bugs or the beneficial insects. So I hope you've learned about a couple of the insects that you can use to fight the bad guys. And that should be one of your first lines of defense, aside from manual control. So what I mean by manual control, I mean picking off the branches that are affected with the bugs, getting them off-site, composting them, getting rid of them, then using the beneficial insects. If the beneficial insects aren't effective, then I start to spray things. So the first thing I'd spray is like high pressure water, then maybe followed by some Dr. Bronner's or some insecticidal soap and some insecticidal oils. Then I just go down the list to maybe a little bit more natural controls that aren't going to harm the environment. So to learn more about the beneficial insects and the beneficial bugs that they offer at Nature's Control, visit their website, naturescontrol.com. Next, we're going to check out another booth. They have a really cool basically plant cage that I've never seen before. Now, this is meant pretty much for indoor growing, as is a lot of the things here, but I'm picking out some cool things that can maybe also be used for outdoor growing. So if you're planting on a deck and you have a plant that you're planting outside, you move it in for the winter, this would actually be a really good cage to keep it stable because it kind of folds down and it's fully adjustable and you're not really going to disturb your roots like you would with other cages or stakes. So this one's called the Ultimate Plant Cage. Here it is being used in real world with some flowers. And let me show you this one. It's set up without flowers so you can see how it works. This is the cage, basically goes into the pot right here, anchors down into the pot. You put this in, obviously, when you plant your plant originally. and it basically has all these little hinges on here. These hinges have these poles on there. These poles go up maybe like 32 inches, and these are elliptical and adjustable, so you literally turn this, you can adjust it higher, and then you turn it to lock it in place. Not only that, you can actually turn it and lower it, we'll lock it into place, and you can grab another one of these guys, you know, adjust this out to be taller, and put it in there. And man, that could get really tall. So this isn't like super sturdy. You could probably grow something like beans or peas that would nice vine up down up this really cool. If you want to make it stronger, you could actually take some string and tie these around to each other. And let's check this one out right here now that they have these flowers growing on. You can see here they have some horticulture wire with rubberized strapped onto these little brackets that go up the plant. So if you strapped all these together all around the whole unit, you'd basically have like a really solid cage that'd be nice and flexible. So definitely really cool. This would probably work really nicely for something like peppers. You know, if you're growing some herbs, you cut the herbs when they're at a young stage, so you make them side shoot, and then you can train each one of these up one of the poles here. Now, I like this a little bit better than sticking like multiple bamboo stakes in, because this won't transfer disease on your bamboo stakes. Sometimes disease may grow on there. With this is plastic. You can put in some you know, water with some bleach to sterilize it, so you won't transfer any pathogens. The other thing I like about this is you can adjust this after you put it in with a bamboo stake. Say you need to put a taller one in, you'll need to re-stake and put another stake, and you're going to disturb the roots. Once you put this in, it's solid, and you can just you know, adjust these as needed, and you don't ever need to disturb the roots. So the ultimate plant cage, I definitely think it's can be useful depending on your growing situation. Now, would I use these in my front raised beds? Probably not. They're really small and rinky-dink, but for the right application, this could be a great solution. So think about that when you need an adjustable plant stake, mostly for indoor or maybe container deck gardening. Now we're gonna walk up to the hydro farm booth. They got a couple really cool things growing on. Let's check it out. So first they got these two guys right here. This is a mega garden. Actually, this is the hydroponic setup that I have in my house. You know, if you're new into hydroponics, it's a great little system to just get you going. It basically includes everything you need except for the plants. Over here is a smaller version. This is called the Emily's Garden. I would highly recommend these two models. They definitely work really good for hydroponics. And now, once again, these are starter setups. You know, they get all kind of crazy stuff. You can assemble and build your own things, but you know, to keep it simple, just get one of these systems, grow inside. Remember, if you're gonna grow inside, you probably also need some supplemental lighting, especially if you're trying to grow vegetables. Vegetables do like some kind of lighting more than just ambient light in your house. But the thing we're here to talk about today is the coolest product I've seen. It's this guy right here. This guy right here is called the Accelerroot. And this is a cutting tray with the plugs for propagating cuttings and seeds. I would personally use this for cuttings because of the way it's set up. It has 50 spots for plants, and basically you can see here, each one of these spots have a little pre-moistened peat and coconut core plug. And check it out, these are already pre-moistened, so you don't even have to put water in there. We can squeeze all the water out of that plug. Besides having the water and pre-moistened, this is already teeming, and they already pre-infused it with mycorrhiza. And you all guys know that I'm really into mycorrhiza, because once the mycorrhiza come in contact with the roots, it basically colonizes and helps the roots pull more nutrition into the plants. So you can have healthier plants and plants that grow larger. So how would I use this Accelerroot kit? I would use this to basically make more plants. So things that are uncommon in my garden, like the stevia, maybe I want more basil plants and I only have one. Actually, basil perpetual, I could take a cutting of the basil perpetual, or my stevia or my tomasio tomatoes that are that patented variety, and stick it in here and check it out. Here's 50 spaces for all these cuttings. I'd stick it in there, put a dome over it, and in about 7 days, I'd have it rooting. And once it roots out, it would look like this pretty much. You see the roots coming out of the plant. At that point, you're ready to transplant that out into a bigger container or even your garden. So with this kit, you're gonna prevent a few things, like number one, overwatering, because these are pre-moistened. You don't have to deal with it. You don't have to think about it. So it makes it real easy. Number two, you're gonna have 20% faster rooting time just because of the way this is set up and the way this is designed, because it's a complete system. And all you need to do is get this system, put some cuttings in here, and you're off-rooting, and you're gonna have more plants. And especially if your plants are special plants that you can't get anywhere else, it's definitely important to clone them at the end of the season, maybe keep them inside and grow them during the winter and then bring them outside so you have a jump on the following season. So this product called Acela Root is going to be available at your local hydroponic store. The retail price is about $17.95. Excellent deal to start and propagate and clone 50 of your plants. So there are so many booths here with different like nutrient solutions and different things to add to your garden, and I'm not really like a big fan of most of them, but here's one that I think everybody should add in the garden. You know, like I use at my house, I use mainly grown in compost, rock dust, which are the things you must use overall else, and then if you had to do a third thing, this is what I'd recommend. This stuff is, this company's called Plant Success, and they make some mycorrhizae. So mycorrhizae is a beneficial fungus that basically will colonize on the roots and help your plants absorb more nutrition. They'll also actually take up less water, and they may need less water, like 20% water, 30% less water on some studies that have been done. So the benefits are you'll have a stronger root system. When you have a stronger root system, the plant's absorbing more things in the root system. That means everything above the root system, like the plant itself and the fruits that you're producing, are gonna be healthier. So the thing that's new at this show here is they have this stuff right here. This is a premium liquid mycorrhizae. So I like that this is in a liquid solution. Besides just the mycorrhizae, this also has a beneficial bacteria. So if you hear about things like compost tea, now this isn't probably a substitute for compost tea, but this has some of the beneficial bacteria that the compost tea would have. So if you don't want to brew your compost tea, get this, you got two birds with one stone, mycorrhizae and the beneficial microbes in a liquid. Now I like the liquid because I have been playing with the mycorrhizae in the powder and the granule form for a long time. I tend to like the granular form a little bit better because the powder is actually a nice fine powder and you could breathe that in. Now it's inherently not dangerous, but any particulate that we're breathing in is definitely not a good thing. So like when you're handling rock dust, you might also want to use a mask. But with this stuff, you can put in a spray bottle and simply spray your roots before you transplant and it'll have its dose of the beneficial microbes and the mycorrhizae. So if you had to choose just one product from Plant Success, I'd recommend this one. This is their endo and ecto mycorrhizae with seaweed and humic acid. So I like this product because not only does it have a lot of different mycorrhizae in it, it also has a humic acid, the seaweed extract, and also the beneficial microbes in there. So this is a one-stop product. Now remember, this stuff does get kind of expensive. I mean, you could buy a big, huge 50-pound bag of rock dust for as low as $15, depending on where you live, or get it by the dump truck load full at your local quarry. But this stuff is gonna run a pretty penny. But remember, you know, you don't wanna be dumping the whole bottle on your plants when you're transplanting. All it takes, one little pinch on the roots, make sure it comes in contact with the root ball and on the roots. Don't put it in the hole, put it directly on the roots. So if you put it on the roots, that'll basically start colonizing on the roots and they'll spread and multiply. Be sure to check my other videos where I actually have a specific video on using this stuff when I'm transplanting my tomato. And actually, I looked at that same tomato that I planted in the video, and that thing is so lush and huge compared to tomatoes that I did not use it on that are still actually remaining in the pots. So I'm definitely a believer in the mycorrhizae, and I like the Plant Success brand. I really have fun at these indoor gardening expos, not only for the things I learned, but the things I get to take away. So I got a bucket hydroponic system. This is from General Hydroponics. I got two big IKEA bags. One side's got a mycorrhizae on it. And then this other side, man, this side is heavy. This side's got some good soil to be growing some stuff in. So you come to these expos like this, bring some big IKEA bags so you can tote a lot of samples out. Hope you've enjoyed this episode, learning more about some of the stuff here available at the Indoor Gardening Expo. This is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. And remember, keep on growing.